Let's begin with a little bit of housekeeping. For these exercises, we're going to use several data files that you will be able to find on the same folder where these videos will be stored. So you will find a file, for example, called a county data. You'll find another one called Gapminder 2012, and then another one called Gapminder all years. If you want, you can open them up in Excel to take a look at them. This is the county data file that includes data such as results from the 2016 presidential elections, percentage of Republican vote, etc., county names, county locations, etc. Then you also have data such as income per capita, percentage of African Americans, percentage of people who are obese, percentage of people who have college degrees, wealth also, you have income per capita. So you have several data points that we can play with later on. And then the Gapminder data, I'm going to open up Gapminder all years. This is data from all over the world, and that includes things such as, I have it open over here, I think. So it includes income per capita, infant mortality, life expectancy, children per woman, that's fertility rate, and so on and so forth. So these are all data that we can play with. The Gapminder data, by the way, is related to the Gapminder website. Gapminder, if you're not aware of that, is the website of the Gapminder Foundation, which was originally founded by a professor of global health in Sweden called Hans Rosling, who sadly passed a few months ago. Hans Rosling was one of the most effective and most famous data presenters of all time. If you want to learn and get some inspiration on how to present data effectively to the public, I would recommend that you go to gapminder.org and you take a look at the video section to take a look at some of the lectures that he gave throughout the years. He was a truly inspiring character who used data visualization all the time in his presentations, right? So I actually Google Hans Rosling charts, and you will find tons of examples of charts that, for example, compare the lifespan country by country, that will be the vertical axis, versus the wealth of each one of these countries, that will be the horizontal axis. And then each one of the bubbles corresponds to a country, bubble size corresponds to the size of the country in terms of population, and then the color corresponds to the continent that those countries belong to. So we are going to learn how to create this kind of graphic very quickly, interactively. All right, we are going to create time sliders and things like that. We are going to create maps, charts, etc., that we can later publish. So let's get started. Well, when you go to Flourish, probably the main website, which is flourish.studio, will look a little bit different, and that is because I'm recording these tutorials before Flourish even launches. All right, so probably this first screen will look different. It will ask you to sign up or to sign in, etc. It will not ask you to join a waiting list, right? Now, to sign in right now, I just can click on these, and then I have already a password. So once you do that, what you will get will be this display over here, right? That's your project's overview of all the projects that you have created so far. Will be displayed over here. You can do, these are the ones that I have created so far. You can obviously erase them or delete them. You can duplicate them if you want. You can do several things with them. And you can create both individual visualizations or stories. We are going to create both kinds. Now, if I click on, for example, let's get started. Let's take a look at how to create a visualization. If I click on new, that will take me to all the catalog of visualizations that Flourish lets you create. So it will show you bubble maps and choropleth maps and pie charts and line graphs and bar graphs, etc., scatter plots, Sankey diagrams, and so on and so forth. Now you will see that on the upper shelf over here you have several options. By default, it's going to show the featured visualizations, right? I don't know if these are the most popular ones. I guess that they are, but there are many other templates that you can use. For example, you can click on All by Flourish, and here you will have many other options that you can use. So there are, for example, election maps from Germany, to which you can upload your own data, UK constituencies. You have Canada maps, world maps, slope charts, and so on and so forth, even 3D globes. Now, if you click on any of these, you will see a sample of the kind of graphic, of how this kind of graphic looks like, because Flourish comes with certain default data sets that are loaded by default to show you how the visualization works. So right now it's loading the 3D globe and the data corresponding to the 3D globe, right? That's another feature of these. So for example, the default data set is trading partners of China, the United Kingdom, and the USA. The globe will appear momentarily here in the middle. So there's a time slider. Do you have the ranking? There's the 3D globe. And then you can just rotate it, right? If you want to take a look at the underlying data of any of the graphics that are on the templates, you can click on the data up here. And this is the data set that is preloaded by default. But as you can see, you can import your own data. Now, the reason why Flourish gives you these by default, shows you these data set by default, is to give you an idea of how data needs to be formatted. So for example, in the case of the 3D globe, right, if you want to format your data correctly, you will need your categories over here, your years over here, the source and the destination, then the trade value. So that should be more or less the format of your data set. So Flourish will load these data correctly when you create the globe. So I would encourage you to just, navigate randomly through the many kinds of visualizations that are available. Just click on new, then click on any of the graphics that appear over there to get a sense of how data is formatted for each one of the graphics that are available, for each one of the templates that are available. By the way, this is just an aside. You may have noticed that on the initial screen it says developer, start building now. And this is because Flourish, besides giving you the option of using pre-existing templates, as long as Flourish is driven by JavaScript and HTML and CSS and so on and so forth, web technologies, if you have a D3 or a JavaScript developer in your team, or if you are a web developer yourself, you will be able to create your own templates that you can add to these, to my templates, okay? So here you have a link that takes you how to build your own templates, all right? So you can create your own JavaScript templates, you can upload them into Flourish, and then you can populate them with your own data, right? So you can basically customize the tool instead of just being limited by the available templates, if you are obviously a knowledgeable in JavaScript and web technologies, which I am not that much, all right? So I will limit myself to these available tools in the next tutorials.